Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. As-salatu wassalamu ala Rasulil Ameen. As we mentioned, the Quran, a book of Allah, clearly mentions that fasting is exempt from the traveler, but they have to make up later. Now, because of that, just like the case of our sisters who go through pregnancies and nursing and all that, they say, the travelers say, man, you know what? I have to make it up later. I'm going to do it now, no matter what. No matter what, I'll do it, you know, because Alhamdulillah, fasting during travel is not haram according to the most Sunni schools. Although, according to the Shia imams, the fasting is haram during fasting because they say you are denying a gift, a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if you are fasting, you should make up later. That's what Quran is saying. So they say, how could you say, well, hold off right here, because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not tell the Sahaba not to fast. He left it optional, although he used to encourage them not to fast while traveling. Yes, like that big hadith of Anas ibn Malik radhiallahu anhu, where he mentioned that Allah has lifted up half of the prayer from the traveler and the fasting. This hadith, Anas said, I wish I took the exemption that Allah gave me through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In that hadith, it's mentioned 2408 and 715 of Tirmidhi, 2408 of Abu Dawud. Now, I tell you a story. 1946 number hadith of Sahih al-Bukhari, a companion was traveling and he was fasting. Remember I told you, he discourages them to fast while traveling, but they still do sometimes, right? This guy was fasting and boy, he collapsed. They were doing a shade on him, trying to put water on his face, you know, get him wake up. He fainted. He passed out. Prophet saw it and he did not like it. When he looks at the man, he says, "Laysa min al-birri as-siyamu fi as-safar." Please memorize that hadith. "Laysa min al-birri as-siyamu fi as-safar." If any brother, any sister is suffering while fasting, tell them that hadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, peace be upon him and his family. Very authentic hadith. 1946 number hadith, not the year, of Sahih al-Bukhari, that fasting while traveling is not going to give you any extra righteousness, extra iman, extra taqwa. It is going to be the same fast that you're going to do today or you're going to make up later. So why hurting yourself? Why killing yourself when you can get the same reward later on? But I'll tell you one other thing. Yes, you can still fast while you're traveling as long as you don't hurt yourself. You got the answer. But when you're not fasting, please be respectful to those who are fasting. Don't just eat in front of everybody. Hey, I'm not fasting. You are. Subhanallah. That's very disrespectful to our brothers and sisters who are fasting, whether they're local or they're travelers. Because let's say you're traveling, you went to somebody's house and they're all fasting and say, man, I want lunch, I want dinner. That's not fair. That's very disrespectful to the month of Ramadan. That is a very beautiful month Allah has given us and the people who are fasting, which really defies the objectives of this month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all and give us the true piety of our hearts and our bodies, inshallah. Wallahu alam.